Hello students, welcome to Standard 10 Physics online class. Students, in our today online class, I am going to continue Unit 5 Acoustics. You know very well that what is meaning for acoustics. Acoustics is the branch of physics which deals with the study of sound. Today I am going to continue the topic reflection at the boundary of rarer medium. In our last online class, we have seen the topic reflection at the boundary of denser medium. So in this picture, the sound wave is traveling from denser medium and then it strikes the rarer medium. You know that sound wave travels as longitudinal wave. And then longitudinal wave is characterized by compression and rarefaction. So the dear students, let me once again explain the topic reflection at the boundary of a denser medium. Reflection at the boundary of a denser medium. Let us consider two medium. First one is a air medium, which is known as rarer. And then second one is a denser medium. Let us take a rigid wall. Rigid wall. You know that sound wave travel as longitudinal wave. So let sound wave travel from left to right. So the region which is high pressure is known as compression, and then the region which is low pressure is known as rarefaction. So sound waves travel as compression C and rarefaction R. Again, compression, and then leave some space for rarefaction, compression, rarefaction, compression, rarefaction, and then compression. So this region is rarefaction. Dear students, suppose compression traveling in air, because this is air medium, compression traveling in air from left to right. So left side to right and reach a rigid wall. So this is a rigid wall. The compression exert, so this is the compression. The compression exert a force F on rigid wall. In turns, the wall exert an equal and opposite reaction. So R equal to the wall exert equal and opposite reaction, R equal to minus F. So the negative sign is for opposite direction, because the wall exert equal force on opposite side on the air molecules. These result in a compression near the rigid wall. So, dear students, thus a compression traveling towards the rigid wall is reflected. So, the compression traveling towards from left to right towards the rigid wall is reflected back, as a compression. C, R, C, R, C. You know that C is for compression and R is for rarefaction. So that is the direction of compression is reversed. Dear students, in figure 5.5, you may clearly notice that sound wave travel as compression and rarefaction from left direction to right, and then it exert equal force by rigid wall and again travel as compression from right to left direction. Thus, compression traveling towards the rigid wall is reflected back as a compression. So that is the direction of compression is reversed is the important point. So the direction of compression which is exerted by the rigid wall is reversed. When sound travel from air medium to denser medium, so which is known as rarer medium to denser medium. Let us move to our next topic, reflection at the boundary of a rarer medium. Reflection of sound at rarer medium. Reflection at the boundary of a rarer medium. Let us consider a wave traveling in a solid medium. So consider denser medium, any solid, striking on the interface. So this is the interface medium. So striking on the interface between solid and air. So this is a denser medium, this is a rarer medium, air. Dear students, the compression exert a force F on the surface of the rarer medium. What is a rarer medium? Air is a rarer medium. As a rarer medium has smaller resistance when compared to denser medium. For any deformation, the surface of separation is pushed backward as the particles of the rarer medium are free to move. Hence, a rarefaction is produced at the interface. See here, in denser medium, sound wave travel as compression, rarefaction, and then strike the rarer medium air, and then it exert the force. Again, denser medium as rarefaction. Here, compression, but the reversed force is rarefaction. Hence, a compression is reflected as a rarefaction, and then rarefaction travel from right to left. Our next topic is reflection of sound in plane and curved surfaces. When sound wave reflected from a plane surface, the reflected waves travel in a direction according to the law of reflection. So we know the two laws of reflection, the reflected wave, incident wave, normal, all are lie in the same plane. And then angle of incidence I is equal to angle of reflection R. So the intensity of the reflected wave is neither decreases nor increased when the sound wave reflected in the plane surface, but when it reflects in concave and convex surface, the intensity will change. So, but when the sound waves reflected from the curved surfaces, the intensity of the reflected wave is changed. So let me explain in convex and concave surface. First, convex surface. So when the reflected from convex surface. The reflected wave are diverged, very important. Diverged meaning it split the sound waves out and the intensity is decreased. Very, very important 1 mark question. So when the sound wave reflected from the convex surface, the reflected wave are diverged out and the intensity is decreased. But when the sound wave is reflected from the concave surface, the reflected waves are converged. Converged meaning focused at particular point. So focused at a point so that the intensity of the reflected wave is concentrated at a point. And then very, very important, in the parabolic surface are used when it required to focus sound at a particular point. Many halls are designed with the parabolic reflecting surface to focus the sound at a particular point. In elliptical surfaces, sound from one focus will always be reflected to the other focus, no matter where it strikes the wall. This principle used in designing whispering hall. So in a whispering hall, the speech of a person standing in one focus can be heard clearly by the listener standing at the other focus. So whispering meaning munumunuthal. Do you know part? A whispering gallery. So one of the famous whispering galleries in a St. Paul Cathedral Church in London. So it is built with elliptically shaped wall. Very important, elliptically shaped wall. So when a person is talking at one focus, his voice can be heard distinctly, clearly at the other focus. So this is due to multiple reflections of sound waves from the curved wall. This is the elliptical shaped wall. So when a person talking at one focus, the sound wave goes on continue reflection and then it can be heard distinctly at the other end. Students, this topic is important for book inside 1 mark. So kindly revise all the topic clearly and then read line by line. Thank you. Have a nice day.